Hello students, welcome to my class. In today's class, we are going to see the Vietnam War. The Vietnam War was fought between 1st November 1955 to 30th April 1975. This is the structure. These are the contents I will be sharing with you in this class. First, objectives, outcome, geographical location map of Vietnam, introduction, circumstances which led to the outbreak of Vietnam War, then the map of North and South divided Vietnam, then major campaigns in which we will be seeing attacks and the counter attacks done by the warring powers, that is America and Russia, during the time of Kennedy and Johnson's presidency, then consequences left by this Vietnam War. The objectives are to know the strategic necessities of USA and USSR, to explain the circumstances of the division of Vietnam, to measure the change in the foreign policy of USA, to outline the strong influence of communism over Indochina. And the outcomes are, at the end of this lecture, you will be able to discuss the strategic necessities of USA and USSR. You will be distinguishing the changes in the foreign policy of USA after this Vietnam War. And you'll be able to analyze the strong influence of communism over Indochina by defeating America. And lastly, you will be assessing the intensity of this Vietnam War. This is a geographical location map. As you can see here, these are red highlighted portions. Okay, so this is the map of Vietnam. It is in the Asian continent. The introduction. The Vietnam War was very long and costliest war ever since happened since the times of Great Wars 1 and 2. And it is a divisive conflict which created tension and, you know, the animistic feeling between the civilians of Vietnam and Americans for a longer time. And the American War was an intensified war by the ongoing Cold War between the United States and the Soviet Union. Vietnam War was combated during three presidents' period, namely John F. Kennedy, Lyndon B. Johnson, and Richard Nixon, respectively. Actually, the problem was the Vietnamese wanted to have the political liberation from the America, like how Indians wanted to came out of the clutches of the Great Britain's colonialism. But there was a difference between the Indians' struggle and the Vietnamese struggle. Actually, the Vietnamese did not raise their voice against that colonial master, that is America. So they did not rebel against America, but what Americans did when they came to sense the sense of freedom among the Vietnamese, the Americans sent their armies. They have bombarded the important cities from sea, air and land, and they have dropped hundreds of tons of bombs. They have slaughtered old, young and innocent infants mercilessly. Let us see the circumstances which led to the outbreak of Vietnam War. Vietnam was considered as the bone of contention between USA and USSR for their own ideological interest, that is communism and the capitalism. Both of the powers, they had their own set of goals to capture this Vietnam. For communists, Vietnam was considered as important for the promotion of world revolution to spread their communist ideology. Americans thought Vietnam was a strategic necessity to exercise their control over Indochina. Indochina is nothing but another name of Vietnam. So the Americans had three set of specific goals to capture this Vietnam. First was to defend the white racist Australia against Asiatic advancement in Asia. Secondly, to maintain the communication system from the Pacific Ocean to the Indian Ocean. So they thought Vietnam as a strategic point, a centric point, or a bridge, a linking bridge between, connecting bridge between Asia and Europe. So they wanted to encroach this portion to promote their commercial interest, commercial benefits. So the last goal to control this Vietnam was, Americans thought the Vietnam could have haunted by, Vietnam might have haunted by the domino theory. What is domino theory? We have seen clearly in the Eisenhower's period. So let us move on to the next slide. This is a map of divided Vietnam. You can see the pink one is North Vietnam and the south one is, the green one is South Vietnam. Let us see how this division was came up. So we have come to the campaign. How the campaign was carried out by each president. So let us see how the America entered into the scene of Vietnam War. In the beginning, actually, it is not a world war. In history, we have two kinds of war, you know. One is civil war and another one is world war. Whenever there is a war or a struggle inside a country between two different groups is called civil rights, you know. War inside a country is civil war, and war outside the country and war with many countries is called a world war. So it is not just World War One and World War Two. So it is a simple strategy. Whenever more than two powers are entering into the scene, it was considered as a world war. Okay, so let us see how the America moved this their, you know, their keys in the internal affairs of Vietnam. So Vietnam was fell victims of power politics in 1940. Before coming of America in the Vietnam's issue, there was already an imperialist regime ruling this Vietnam. It was France. Okay, so America in 1940, America furnished a massive aid to Vietnamese against the imperialist France. So America wanted to push out this France so that they can enter inside. So for that, America furnished a lots of aid and money to the Vietnamese to exile this France. But what French did, you know? The French persuaded Emperor Bao Doi to organize a government with Saigon as a capital. So they somehow, the French balanced the anti-French feeling by supporting Bao Doi. Okay, so Bao Doi now established his government in the North Vietnam, one portion of Vietnam. So he was a strong believer of communism. So this portion, the area which was ruled by Bao Doi was called as the pro-red Vietnam. So the North Vietnam was called as pro-red. Pro-red is nothing but supporting the red idea. What is red idea? Red is nothing, a communist idea. Okay. So the portion ruled by Bao Doi was considered as the pro-red North Vietnam. And another remaining portion is South Vietnam. The South Vietnam was also ruled by a communist believer, communist-led leader, Ho Chi Minh. So he established his government with Hanoi as its capital. He was a communist, but he did not want to follow an exact communist ideology, because most of the South Vietnamese were against the communist ideology. So he maintained a parallel administration. So we could say pro-red, those who were supporting the communist ideology in the North, they were called as pro-red. Those who were against communist ideology in the South, they were called as anti-red South Vietnam. So when the Vietnam was divided, there was urge for a compromise, because there existed a political chaos. So to end that political chaos, there was a meeting arranged by both Vietnamese, both Vietnam, North and South Vietnam. So this conference was arranged in Geneva in the year 1954. In this conference, major important delegates were attended, including America, Russia and France. So in this conference, there were two points were discussed. One was demarcating the territorial boundary, that was called as 17th parallel. Okay, so the first objective of this conference was 17th parallel demarcation, and second was to questioning the will of the people, whether the people of Vietnam wanted to remain as divided South Vietnam, or they wanted to have the reunification of Vietnam. So these are the two things discussed in this Geneva conference. However, Dinh Dinh repudiated the settlement, fearing the reunification. So Dinh Dinh was a new leader who took charge in the South Vietnam. Okay, so he don't want to unite the Vietnam, because if it is reunited, he will be losing his position. So the Vietnam will be transformed as a whole whole red Vietnam, the whole communist Vietnam. So he don't want to reunify it. So what the pro-communist leader did, you know, when the feeling was arisen of reunification, and when he sensed the fear of Dien Bien, the leader of South, he maintained, he organized a parallel administration. He proposed lots of compromising and lots of, you know, smooth plans supporting the South Vietnam people. So as this was seen by the American government, so this in that time Kennedy was the president. So he don't like the attitude of the pro-communist leader. If Kennedy led the pro-communist leader's attitude continue, then South Vietnam will be taken up by the North Vietnam. So the Kennedy sent his military forces to control the North Vietnam to spread the communist ideology to the South, but this attempt had no perceptible impact. So it was considered as a failed one. In the year 1963, this had spread with Dien Bien. Dien Bien was a pro-American interest, the leader of South Vietnam now. So the Kennedy was not satisfied with the administration of Dien Bien. So there was a plot of conspiracy was went on between the American interest, those the American officials in the South Vietnam, and the American, you know, the White House people. Though they made a plot against this Dien Bien, and they murdered this guy. So there was a need of new leader. Diu elected, a person called Diu was elected through the presidency in the South Vietnam. So he is a new leader in the South Vietnam. And so with that, Kennedy's period was over, and Lyndon B. Johnson came to power. During his period, only the transition of leader was occurred. Okay, so the new leader came to power, and again there was a chaos, political chaos in the South Vietnam. So Lyndon B. Johnson sent American destroyers. American destroyers is nothing but the warship to the North Vietnam territorial waters in the place Gulf of Tonkin. So in retaliation, in 1964, there was a provocation of communist gunboats. Communist gunboats is nothing. Gunboat is also a warship. So this gained the attack of communists over the American boat, gained a remarkable victory, but it reminded a momentary. So in the year 1968, when the Americans felt, the setback, Johnson, Lyndon B. Johnson announced halts of bombardments. Subsequently, warring parties agreed for discussion. So in the year 1968, there was another conference was met in Paris. So in this conference, the North Vietnamese demanded evacuation of Americans from the North Vietnam as well as from the South Vietnam. But the Americans did not, they did not obey this. They did not want to go out of America. So the war, when they did not obey to the request of the North Vietnam, the war was continued, but not so longer. So it can taken as when the North Vietnam demanded America to go out of the Vietnam, and when the America stepped back, it was considered as a failure of America. So even though war was continued, the Vietnamese, the North Vietnam, with the support of the Chinese power, Russia, they gained a continuous momentum, and there we could feel the gradual failure of the America. But it not went so longer, and we came to the consequences of the Vietnam War. We can say the result of Vietnam War. This Vietnam was considered as a failure of American foreign policy, because the North Vietnam, supported by the communist ideology, Russia and China, they defeated all of the attempts of America. And as war continued, America slowed down their attitude in the American in the Vietnamese issue. So this Vietnam War was considered as a major failure of foreign policy of the United States. Though 6 lakh American troops and 7 lakh of South Vietnamese forces involved, it did not work. So it was openly seen that America was failed in this Vietnam War. Finally, Lyndon B. Johnson called upon Ho Chi Minh, president of North Vietnam, for the peace talk. So this was, so we came to an end.